Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the show. We continue in a minute, and we have a very special jewelry designer over here. She is chatting with the group from the Belmer. just turn it around. You see, ladies and gentlemen, there's already a lot of interaction. This is typical winter salon. The designers talk to each other. Please, you have.
Yeah, I want to have their opinion because the reason.
Yeah, sure.
T-shirts.
Yeah, sure.
And they like this, huh? Yeah.
Yes.
That's a very good one.
Okay. Can you please introduce yourself? Sorry.
Yes. Where do I have? I'm Josephine Coulson.
Oh wait, please come over here. Come here. Okay, we do that one more time, ladies and gentlemen. Josephine, please introduce yourself.
I'm Josephine Coulson, and I'm a designer. In the moment, I design jewelry, which is over there.
What struck me immediately when I first saw you was this beautiful jewelry that you have.
Thank you. Yes.
You brought us some really nice designs. Maybe we can just have a look at them, and we have a close look at them, I mean. What I do is I give you the microphone, so you can, if you point and command on them, then I can put the camera.
So
in.
I'll tell yes, a little please. Bit about every jewel. Yes. Okay. This one, I'll start with this one. It is inspired on a painting of Mondrian, the Dutch painter, and I made a little change in it. But I wanted to honor him because I'm really I admire very much his work. This one is a totally different one. It's an other side of me. It's a more romantic side that I like very much too. And it's called filigrane. It's a kind of way of working metal.
I always understood this filigrane is very. Requires a very high skill
yes,
level to make.
This is not. This is a slight copy of real filigrane because okay. If you look at the real filigrane, it's all little metal cords yes, and yes. They wrap it around the thing. Okay. And this is I buy it in France. And
okay.
They make it
okay.
In small quantities, right. But it's not totally done by hand. Let's say
okay.
That.
Okay.
And then I'll continue.
Yes, please.
Yes. And this is the third one. This is an inspiration. I was inspired by a part of the city of Amsterdam because I wanted to make some souvenir jewelry.
All right.
And this is a part of the Grachtengordel.
All right.
I don't know the translation for Grachten. The Amsterdam canals, but then in the center of Amsterdam. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And I made another one. This was the first one I made of the canals in Amsterdam, and it's well, the guys liked it very much.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
And this one, I started to think about these kind of designs. I thought, well, maybe we should go back to very simple things that we use every day and that it's not too bombastic.
Yes.
And then, of course, with a certain memory of old times. And I should call this the series of the daily life jewelry because it's a little camera and I also have one with a little iPhone and an iron board.
Yes.
An iron. Strijkijzer?
Yeah.
An iron, yes. So, and this one is called the Camé Camera. And then this one is, yeah, totally different, but also a part of my designing in which I'm very interested. It's this part of the necklace comes from a part in Mali. There is a tribe, and they live in Mali, in Ivory Coast, Côte d'Ivoire.
Mm-hmm.
And they make these kind of things.
Okay.
And this is more or less, how to say, all kind of things I found. This one I found in Paris, this one too, and I put it together.
Okay.
So these are the main things of my collection. But I hope I will continue and make more pieces.
Yeah, thanks very much for that, for showing us that. You are also part of Salon.
Yes, I am a location.
You are, sorry? You are a location as well? That is interesting, tell me about that. You don't look like a location to me.
Oh, you don't know. Yeah, well, the down part of my house is installed as a part of the Salon, and the two people we're exposing in my house are Cornelia Edwards. She did a research on the behavior of people in shops, in fashion shops, and she put an installation in my room. And the other artist who exposes in my house is Karin Aring, do I say it right? Yes. And she made very beautiful, very simple drawings.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. And so you are involved with Salon already for maybe from the beginning, I'm not sure?
Oh, longer than you
Longer
think.
Than that.
Okay.
What I'm trying to explore also in the interviews,
yes,
is Salon is very successful.
Yes.
It's very let's say uncommon in a way that everybody contributes and works together.
Yes.
Very unusual.
Yes.
For me, as Salon living here in Amsterdam, everybody is more. But Salon is an exception on that.
Yes.
Where does it come from, you think?
From Gijs,
okay,
and
yeah.
Manon, and yes. But I think it's a kind of thing that is almost necessary in this time, because everybody becomes very individualistic,
yes,
and a lot of things, and a lot of people are all the time only behind their computer, and I think it's very important that that there is a change in society, and I hear a lot of people talking about it, and Salon is definitely a part of it,
yes,
I think.
Yes.
Because they bring people together, it's very pleasant to be together, to work together, to speak together, so it's a very good initiative.
Okay.
I'm very glad with it.
Yeah, yeah. Because the success is quite clear, it's growing.
Yes.
Version after version is coming out.
Yes.
There's now all, I think, only Australia is not covered yet as a continent, but
Antarctica, I think. Neither, no.
Okay.
Yes, I think so. Yeah. Lace part in Antarctica.
Yeah, yeah.
When the climate continues like that, it will grow by itself.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. And because what I see is at one side you see also in fashion and maybe also design, you see these very large global brands that really like dominate,
yes,
the market,
yes,
and
yes,
on the other side you see more individual designers,
yes,
that are now seem to team up to work together.
Well, what is going to happen, because I can I talk about my little shop sometime? Well, I,
sure.
I play shop, let's say, 3 days a week, and I had recently two clients coming in, and they said this is such a relief that we find these small shops with their own products, so that we don't have to go all the time to all the big shops where they sell all the same things. So the people, even if they are not in fashion, they start, I think, also a little bit to be fed up with the one thing, you know. Everything looks alike, even if you look at the fashion shows, it's all one big thing. You wonder what it's all about in a moment. Is it about creation? Is it only about money? What is it?
Yes.
So, and I think it's going to change, definitely.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the end of a time.
Yeah. Or the beginning of a time.
Well, there always has to be an end before,
yes,
it begins again.
Yeah, you expect worse? You expect really like a crash in the fashion industry as well?
I don't think, well, I'm not sure about that. It could be that it gets worse. Yes, I think so. Could be.
Yeah. And how is that in Amsterdam? I mean, Amsterdam is really working hard as a city to promote fashion, to,
yes,
promote
yes,
like this, the heritage, the art,
yes,
the design. And I have the feeling that with fashion, at least, that they are kind of coming up now. Or is that, how do you look at that? I mean, we have Fashion Week, we have all kind of fashion events here. How do you look at that?
Well, the big problem is that when you make fashion, the fashion is for people, you know, it's clothes. So the main thing should be that the person who wears the clothes should feel good in it. And what I see in the moment is that there is not enough research to dress the human being of tomorrow. There are maybe one or two designers in Holland who develop really interesting fabrics. That could be, can I say the name? Borin, for example, Borin Akkersdijk. I think he really develops interesting fabrics. It's a little bit high tech, but that could be great. But that's what I don't see enough.
I think we have the material over here. Should I have a look at it?
Oh yeah, that's it. It's still a little bit heavy. Yeah, I'm old.
Please come into the.
Yeah, it should be.
In what sense is this high tech? You said it's maybe
high
tech.
What he does, it is knitted, and he puts a thing inside, kind of fabric or a yarn. I don't know what it is exactly. Okay. Some material inside, and then it is treated, and it blows up.
Yes.
It's no stitching at all, and I think it is, and it keeps very warm.
Yes.
So it is a really interesting fabric. I have never seen this kind of thing before. So, and that's what I find interesting, yes. And that's what I don't see enough.
Ah, okay, yes. Is it also that you then say, because this has very much to do with ways of producing stuff with
yes,
manufacturing, yes. Technology.
Yes.
We had with Hester Vlamings also a discussion about that, that she can now design or make shoes. That was not possible. Possible a couple of years ago.
She mentioned on the 3D printer.
No, not only that, but she mentioned the nose of a shoe that was not possible years back. Now she can do it.
Oh, definitely.
Is that something? That is, I mean, traditionally, I would think then of Germany with making this manufacturing technology. Is that something Dutch as well, you think?
I think it's something from all countries. There are always several countries who are very innovative in fashion. Yeah. But I don't see exactly where is the center in the moment.
No.
I couldn't tell that.
Is Amsterdam part of the core of that development?
I will not answer on that question.
Okay. I'm just trying.
I worked a long time in France in the fashion industry, so I have a certain opinion about fashion.
Yeah, because some people say, listen, we have Paris, we have London, we have New York. It's nice what they're doing in Amsterdam, but it's not really relevant.
That especially if you work for certain designers, you have to, the person who is inside the clothes is the most important. And then when you make a good design, then you're a good designer. And that's very difficult.
Yes.
If you want to be new, and I think he, with his fabrics, he could do that.
Yes.
Yeah.
So there is hope for Dutch fashion and design?
Oh, but for everybody is hope, even for me.
Okay. All right. Well, that is a very nice ending of this interview. I thank you very much. I hope
You're
to see
welcome.
You maybe next time at Salon sometime.
And, yes, there will be a lace.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, if there's anything that you want to tell to the audience, I mean, go ahead.
Well, then I will be a lace angel with lace wings, I think.
All right. So that is in the next Salon, which
I have no idea. Maybe. Because that's also, if you speak about techniques, there are a lot of difficult techniques in the lace, also in the industry. It's really, really difficult.
Yeah. And also very interesting because it goes so long back.
In
history,
yes.
The technique we discussed, I forgot the name, the embroidery last show, also a very old technique that you see now being picked up again. Let's see what happens with lace in the next Salon. I'm happy to invite you then to come over and give your expert view on that.
Definitely.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, this was it. We're going to go out for a break again, and we will be back in a couple of minutes.